Hello, today we shall do some numericals on doubling. So let us first understand how to calculate a resultant count, both in direct as well as indirect system. So in the direct system, the resultant count would be the sum of all the component linear densities. That is, if R is the resultant linear density, then R1, R2, R3 are the component yarn linear densities here, where R is directly equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So as an example, if two yarns of 40 techs each are twisted together, then the resultant yarn would be 80 techs. So we have directly added 40 plus 40, two yarns, which is 80 techs. The doubled yarn would be represented as 80 by 2, where 80 is the resultant yarn number. So now we come to the indirect system. In the indirect system, 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 and so on, where R is the resultant count and R1, R2, R3 are the component yarn counts. So as an example, if two yarns of 40 English count are twisted together, then the resultant yarn count is 20. So it is 1 by 40 plus 1 by 40, which will be 2 by 40, and when you inverse it, you get the answer as 20. The doubled yarn would be represented as 2 by 40, where 40 is the single yarn count. So there's a difference here. Here 80 is the resultant yarn count, whereas here 40, which is shown here, is the single or the component yarn count. So this difference must be remembered whenever we solve our problems. So here we have one problem to solve, doubled yarn, which is for a two ply. So if 20s and 40s yarn are doubled, then we have to calculate the resultant count. So the solution would be the count of the doubled yarn. So this is 40s, which is a English count or an indirect system. So we'll use the formula 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon 20 plus 1 upon 40. When you solve this, you get 3 upon 40. But we must remember this is equal to 1 upon R. So we need to inverse this. So R is equal to 13.33 count. So the resultant count of the doubled yarn is 13.33. So with this, we come to the next problem. We'll calculate the resultant when yarn count is expressed in different systems. So here there's a problem that is given. A sweater is knitted with two different yarns, 2 by 32 is ME, 100% cotton yarn, and 84 denier, 85 15 nylon lycra yarn. Calculate the resultant count and the percentage by weight of the two yarns used. The cotton yarn is doubled yarn, therefore it is 2 by 32, and therefore the resultant count of this particular cotton yarn would be 16. The nylon lycra yarn is an 84 denier linear density, so we just convert it to techs by dividing it by 9 here, and which would be equivalent to 63.27 English count. When we divide 590.5 divide by this 9.33, we get 63.27 English count. So we have to bring both the yarns in the same system, and here we have this was an English count already. So we have converted this denier into English count, and now we are going to use it both of them in the formula for resultant count in the indirect system. So 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon 16, which is the cotton, plus 1 upon 63.27, which is the nylon lycra yarn, and then we just calculate this. We get this answer as 0.0783, but again this is 1 upon R, so we need to inverse this, and therefore the resultant count here would be 12.77 English count. So the cotton yarn is now the second part of the problem is that we need to calculate the percentage by weight of the two yarns used. So the cotton yarn is 0.0625, that is this particular number divided by the total, since these are all in proportion. So we divide this directly, multiply by 100, I would get 79.8%. And the nylon lycra yarn is 0.016 divided by 0.0783, which is the total here for this particular component. Multiply by 100, we get 20.2% by weight. So we must always check that if it is by percentage, when you add both of them, you get a 100% figure. so that we know that our answers are correct. We come to another problem in which cabled yarn is produced. A yarn of 30s is doubled and three such doubled yarns are plied together. We need to calculate the count of this 6 ply yarn. So the count of the doubled yarn is, so the first doubled yarn, that is 30s, is doubled. So we take this, we calculate 1 upon r is equal to 1 upon 30 plus 1 upon 30. Since there are two yarns, that is equal to 2 by 30. So r will be 30 by 2, which is 15s. If three such yarns are now plied together, so 15s, this doubled yarn, we are taking three of them and we are going to cable it. So it would be 1 upon 15 plus 1 upon 15 plus 1 upon 15 three times, which is equal to 3 upon 15. And again, we must remember that r is going to be inverse of this. So the resultant count of this final 6 ply yarn is going to be 15 by 3, that is 5. Coming to the next problem on cabled yarns, if 40s, two yarns of 50s and one yarn of 60s cotton are cabled together, then calculate the resultant count. So this is again a simple problem. The count of the doubled yarn is 1 upon r, which is equal to 1 upon 50 plus 1 upon 50. That is the this particular yarn we are talking about, which we are going to use in the cabled yarn. So first, since this is a doubled yarn, we calculate the resultant of this yarn first, and we get the answer as 25. Now we use this to find out the resultant of the entire cabled yarn. The resultant count of the cabled yarn is 1 by 40, that is the first yarn, plus 1 by 25, which is the second double yarn that we have used, and it is plus 1 by 60. And now just calculating this in this manner, we get the answer as the resultant count of the doubled or the cabled yarn is 12.24 English count. So coming to the next problem of calculating the single yarn count. Calculate the count of the single yarn that is needed to be doubled with a 50s cotton yarn to give a resultant yarn count of 20s. So in this case, we do not know one of the components. We know the resultant, so we put it substitute in this manner. 1 by 20, which is the resultant, is equal to 1 upon x, which we don't know, plus 1 upon 50s. And then this is easy to calculate. We take 1 upon x on one side and taking 1 by 50 on the other side, we get 1 upon x is equal to 3 upon 100. Again, this x is what we need to find out. So we inverse this and therefore x is equal to 33.33. The count of the single yarn that is needed to be doubled with a 50s yarn to get a resultant count of 20s is 33.33. So this is the answer that we are asked to calculate. So now we come to the next problem, calculating the weight of the yarn. So how do we calculate the weight of each component yarn? That is what we are going to learn. So the problem is like this. Calculate the weight of each count that will be required to produce 100 pounds of resultant yarn if 40s and 60s are doubled. The count of the doubled yarn is 1 upon r is equal to 1 upon 40 plus 1 upon 60. First we find the resultant, that is. And we just do this. 1 upon 40 is equal to 0.025, 1 upon 60 is 0.0167, and the total is 0.04167. So we have all these three figures with us, and therefore the weight of the 40s, so this is your first component, and to find out weight, since all this is in proportion, what we do is 0.025 divided by the total, that is 0.04167, and since we are asked to calculate the proportion, or rather it is in 100 pounds. So we take this entire weight here and we get 60 pounds. So weight of 40s that is required is 60 pounds. Similarly, we calculate for 60s, where we take this particular figure, which is a proportion of 60s yarn in the final yarn. So 0.0167 divided by 0.04167 multiplied by again 100, since 100 pounds is the total weight of the resultant yarn that is produced. So we get the answer as 40 pounds. So always we can always check on our answers. We see that 60 and 40 leads to 100 pounds. So these two yarns are doubled in this particular proportion. To produce 100 pounds of doubled yarn, the doubled yarn count is 24 if we were to calculate this. We need 60 pounds of 40s yarn and 40 pounds of 60s yarn to make this 100 pounds. So coming to the next problem, where you calculate the weight of the yarn for a cabled yarn. So the problem is goes like this: calculate the weight of each count that will be required to produce 144 pounds of resultant yarn if 12s, 18s and 36 yarns are cabled. So again, we calculate the resultant count by using the formula 1 by r is equal to 1 by 12 plus 1 by 18 plus 1 by 36, since these are the three components that are used. So you find out the proportion for all the three and find the total. And by using these, we can easily find out weight of the 12 yarn, that is this particular number 0.0833 divided by the total 0.1666 multiplied by 144, because this is the total weight of the yarn, the resultant yarn that is being produced. So we get 72 pounds is a weight of this particular component in the final yarn. So weight of 18's yarn is to be found out, then we take this particular number, because 1 by 18 is 0.0555 divided by the total, that is 0.1666 multiplied by 144, that is equal to 48 pounds. Similarly, we can calculate for 36's yarn, where we take 0.0278 divided by the total, that is 0.1666 multiplied by 144, where we get 24 pounds. So just for confirmation whether our calculations are correct, we add all the three and see that we get 144 pounds, which is the final weight of the resultant yarn. So to produce 144 pounds of doubled yarn, the doubled yarn count, if we were to calculate from here, inverse of this particular number, we get the answer as 6. So the doubled yarn to produce 6's yarn of to the extent of 144 pounds, we will require 72 pounds of 12's yarn, 42 pounds of 18's yarn and 24 pounds of 36's yarn. So now we come to the next problem, where we calculate the weight of the yarn. Again, it's a problem based on doubled yarn. A manufacturer, told to us that a manufacturer has a stock of 200 pounds of 30's cotton yarn, and he decides to use it. It is there in stock for a long time, so he decides to use it for a fabric which requires 2 by 20's yarn. Actually, in the fabric, the person requires 2 by 20's yarn, but since he has got 30's cotton yarn in stock and he has got around 200 pounds of it in stock, so he would like to use it. So what we are asked to do is calculate the count of the single yarn that must be twisted with this 30's to produce a similar yarn count, which is similar to 2 by 20's. And we are also asked to calculate the weight of the yarn that will be needed for the entire this particular stock of his 200 pounds of 30's to be used up. So there are two things that are asked of us here. So first, let us calculate the count of the single yarn that must be doubled with 30's to give us a similar yarn. So the count of the final doubled yarn required, that means we want our the yarn that we are going to finally produce to be similar to this particular yarn, which is 2 by 20. So basically what we are asking is, we are wanting a doubled yarn of 10s. And therefore, substituting in the formula 1 upon 10 is equal to 1 upon 30, since this is what we have already in stock. And this is what we need to find out, which yarn count should I take so that I get the resultant as 10s. So solving this problem, we get X as the yarn needed to be doubled with 30's yarn to get a 2 ply yarn of 10's resultant count is 15. So this X would be 15. I would need to buy a yarn which is of 15's count. So therefore, this particular equation now can be easily written as, since this is the 1 by 10, which is 0.1, which is made up of two components, that is 1 by 30, that is 0.0333, and this X we have just found out, it is 15. So we get the 1 by 15 as 0.0667. So this would be our the proportions in which these two component yarns are divided. So we have been given that the 30's component yarn weight that we have in stock is 200 pounds. So we can easily write the equation like this, just like before. this is your component 0.0333, which is a part of the total yarn, that is 0.1. So 0.0333 divided by 0.1 multiply by the total weight of the resultant yarn, which we do not know. If we were to multiply this, we would get the component yarn weight, which is given to us, which is 200 pounds. So using this particular formula, we can find out this unknown factor here. So the total weight of the resultant yarn would be 600 pounds. If we were to make this particular yarn using 200 pounds of 30s cotton yarn and some X amount of 15s yarn, we would get a total weight of the resultant yarn as 600 pounds. So we can now easily calculate how much of 15's count I need to buy, which is a difference between 600 and 200. So therefore, the weight of the 15's yarn that is needed to be doubled with 30's to give a yarn similar to 2x20's is 600 minus 200, that is 400 pounds. So with this, we come to the next type of problem where we consider contraction. Up till now, whatever problems we have seen, we have not considered contraction as a factor. So let us first understand what contraction means. So when twist is inserted in a yarn, the yarn contracts and it becomes coarse. So due to the contraction during twisting, the actual length delivered is less than the expected length. So since the yarn delivered is coarser than the yarn expected, contraction percentage can be expressed as nominal count minus actual count divided by nominal count into 100. So a similar phenomenon is seen in the ring frame where we insert twist, and there we can also express contraction as a mechanical draft minus actual draft upon mechanical draft into 100. And this is because as soon as you insert twist, the yarn becomes coarser, and therefore the draft, there would be a difference between mechanical draft and actual draft. And in this particular case, since the yarn becomes coarser, the mechanical draft would be higher than actual draft, and therefore we can find out contraction percentage in this manner. And this would be unlike other processes like comber, where noil is extracted, and in that case actual draft was more than mechanical draft. So due to contraction, this formula changes. It becomes mechanical draft minus actual draft divided by mechanical draft into 100. So after understanding this, let us understand exactly if contraction percentage is given to us, how do we calculate, or how do we go about solving the problem. So understanding contraction percentage, when I say there is a 2% contraction, it means that 100 yards of the original length of the yarn, if I were to use a component yarn which is of 100 yards, after twisting, if there is a contraction of 2%, then the final yarn that is delivered would only be 98 yards, because this 2 yards difference it has come in because there is a 2 yards of contraction that has happened. That means 2% contraction has happened. So during twisting, this phenomenon occurs. So therefore, to produce, now if I normally when a customer gives an order, he will tell you, I want say 100 yards of resultant yarn. So we need to calculate backwards and see how much of the constituent yarn I need to use. So therefore, to produce 100 yards of resultant yarn, it is necessary to feed extra length. Because we have seen in this earlier example given here that if you feed 100, I get 98. So if I were to want 100 yards of resultant, then how much of extra length should I feed so that my final resultant yarn is 100 yards? So this amount needs to be calculated as follows. So to produce 98 yards of resultant, 100 yards of the constituent yarn is required to be fed. Therefore, to produce 100 yards of resultant, the length of the constituent yarn that is needed is, now if you observe here, under the resultant that is there in the previous statement, exactly under that, I've written 100 yards of resultant that is required to be produced. So this is a simple case of cross multiplication. So 100 into 100 divided by 98 would give me the length of the constituent yarn that is needed here. So 100 into 100 divided by 98. and the answer is 102.04 yards. It means that if I want 100 yards of resultant with a 2% contraction, I need to feed 102.04 yards of that particular component which has 2% contraction. So with this background, let us see one of the problems considering contraction percentage. So if two yarns 24s and 36s are doubled and there is a contraction of 3% and 4% respectively, calculate the resultant count considering contraction here. So with 3% contraction, the 24s yarn needed is 100 into 100 upon 97. What we have seen in the earlier, we have understood contraction percentage. Using that, you get for every 100 yards of doubled yarn delivered, we need 103.09 yards of 24s yarn here, which has got 3% contraction. So similarly, with 4% contraction for 36s yarn, we will need 100 into 100 upon 96 because there is 4% contraction. So for 100 yards of double yarn delivery, I will need 104.16 yards of 36s yarn. So having calculated these two, I can use this now directly in the formula, the count of the double yarn. Now slightly this, there's a modification. In the numerator, I'm going to add here, since I'm wanting resultant yarn of 100 yards. So 100 yards divided by R is equal to, this is the yards that is required to produce this of 24. So 103.09, which we just calculated, divided by 24. And for 36s, I need 104. So 104.16 divided by 36. So I get this equation and we find out this ratio here and we get 4.3 and 2.89 respectively. Total is 7.19. So therefore, the resultant is 13.9. We must remember to reverse this and solve this problem in this manner. So you get R is equal to 13.9. The resultant count of the doubled yarn is 13.9. But we must note here that without considering contraction, if I were to calculate the resultant count, that means if we don't use this 100, 103, 104 in the numerator, in a normal way, I would have got the resultant count to be 14.29, which is quite different from 13.9. So it is observed that the resultant yarn is actually coarser. That is, it is 13.9, whereas the expected count was 14.29. So when we were expecting by a normal calculation that we should be getting a 14.29 yarn, due to twisting and contraction that is happening and the yarn becomes coarser because of that, and we find that we have actually got a count of 13.9, which is quite a huge difference between the two. So therefore, it is important to remember this when producing double yarn, that if we are wanting a certain count, then we must actually calculate what amount of yarn or how much contraction is going to happen. Only after considering that we should go for the production, otherwise we are bound to get different count than what we might have expected. So now coming to the this particular problem where we are going to calculate the same thing in direct system. If the values are given in direct system, if we consider shrinkage, how do we calculate the resultant? So the problem is calculate the resultant yarn linear density in tex. This is a direct system. Now if 12 yards of resultant yarn requires 16 yards of 4 tex, 15 yards of 8 tex, and 12 yards of 20 tex component yarns. So the formula here now is slightly modified. So instead of 12 upon R is equal to 16 upon 4 plus 15 upon 8, which would have been a normal formula in case of an indirect system, here it gets modified here, which becomes 12, which is the length, multiplied by the resultant the linear density in direct system, which is equal to 16, that is length, into 4 plus 15 into 8 plus 12 into 20 ticks. Now how this formula has got modified, you can easily check by there's a hint here. By using this particular formula, ticks is equal to 595.5 divided by English count in the previous formula. we can easily modify, we can get this particular modified formula here. So therefore we can calculate R from this particular equation. So if we were to calculate this, the resultant yarn linear density in this case would be 35.33 tex. So with this, we come to the end of today's session. Thank you.